What's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another LaunchBox news video. Today, we're releasing LaunchBox version 13.22 for Windows, and with this, we've got fixes, improvements, and some really great new features. In this video, I'm going to go over the new features and improvements, but keep in mind, we've got a full change log listed up over on the website. We'll leave a link in the description for that. But with that out of the way, let's go ahead and jump into it. Starting out here with a highly requested new feature, LaunchBox can now auto-log in to RetroAchievements, and this supports emulators like RetroArch, Dolphin, and PCSX2. And in this new version of LaunchBox, 13.22, we've done a lot with RetroAchievements and achievements in general when it comes to your retro games. So we've got a lot of new features here that pertain to this, and the first thing I want to show you here is the new Connect to RetroAchievements. So from Tools, if we go to Achievements, we've got a new section here. Connect to RetroAchievements. With this, you will need your username, password, and your API key. Basically, what you need to do is sign in or create an account over at RetroAchievements. From your profile over at RetroAchievements, you're just going to scroll down a bit and find the keys section. The web API key is what we need, so you can copy it and paste it inside of LaunchBox. Once I've got my username, password, and my API key, I can scan now. And this is just going to scan through all of my games and find the games that are compatible with RetroAchievements. And again, emulators like RetroArch, Dolphin, and PCSX2 do support it, but not all games are supported. You can actually find a list over on the RetroAchievements website, or with our new badge system and our progress system, it's really easy to do it from within LaunchBox and Big Box. Now that the scan is complete, we can start earning our RetroAchievements. But there's a few more things that I want to show you here. We'll get to the badges and the new progress system in just a bit. But if we go to our Tools, Manage, Emulators, you can manually turn off the auto RetroAchievements login per emulator. So for instance, Dolphin Emulator right here, we'll go to Edit. Right at the bottom, we've got our RetroAchievements. Login on game launch, you can disable this. Enable hardcore mode. It's really up to you. We need to update the settings there. We're logged in on my account. And as soon as I start a game up, it's going to log me in and it'll track my progress as I play the game. Another one that supports it is RetroArch. And this is one that I always want to leave on. So if we edit this right down here, I'm logged in. I've got hardcore mode on. And this is exactly how I want it to be when I launch a game. But again, it can be totally disabled from here per emulator. And just a quick tip, if you're looking for games that support RetroAchievements, we've got a badge option that shows us if achievements are available per game. So from View, go to Badges, Game Attributes, Enable Achievements, and we've got a new progress system that I want to talk about now. So this is actually really great. For instance, Sarge's Heroes, right down here, looks like we've got a new badge. This game is active in progress. This is a game that I started that I do want to complete. I want to earn RetroAchievements for it. But this is a new feature inside of LaunchBox and Big Box that's really awesome. And when we go to launch a game, I'm going to be using RetroArch for this. It'll come up and we get our on-screen notification letting us know that we've successfully logged into RetroAchievements. It'll also give us a little bit of a progress update in the top left-hand corner. The next new feature I want to give you a look at is game progress tracking, and this can work with individual games. So we right click, we're going to go to Edit, Edit Metadata and Media. From here, we've got a new progress section. Our dropdown, Active in Progress, is what's going on right now with this game. And these fields are organized into categories and values. So the first word is going to be our category. Second word is going to be the value. And from the dropdown, we can manually change this if we need to. So active, in progress, continuous, paused, going down to done, beaten, done, completed. We'll go to continuous here. We'll choose OK. And we've now changed the value of that category. We've also got that new badge here. So it's active, continuous. And along with this, we can even add our own categories and values. So for instance, if I'm playing a game and let's say I'm stuck in the game, I can create a new one as active, but stuck. We'll choose OK. Now, if I go back in here, we can actually reorder everything. Right over here, we've got this gear icon. And you can see under active, we've got stuck here. You can move this up. You can move it down. but you can create new categories and items here, and we can reorganize directly from here. So we can move this all the way up. We'll choose OK, OK. And now we've got our active stuck right at the top here. So from this gear icon, you can organize and add new items. Make sure we choose OK. We'll have to choose OK one more time for everything to save correctly. And these progress updates can be automated with the new Game Progress Automation System. This is going to be located under Tools. We're going to go to Options. From Data, Game Progress Automation. We've also got Game Progress Organization. But from here, you can see how the game progress is tracked. Games with a playtime greater than the following, and this is in minutes, you can change it. I'm at 10 minutes. This is going to be active in progress. Games where you've earned at least one achievement from any source, active in progress. Games you've beaten with retro achievements in softcore mode, done, beaten. Games you've beaten with retro achievements in hardcore mode, done, beaten. Games that you've earned every achievement from retro achievements, done, completed. Games where you've earned every achievement in hardcore mode from retro achievements is going to be marked done, mastered. So this is great for tracking the progress. And remember, with the new progress badges, if you're using a badge theme set, you may want to update. So from Tools, Manage, LaunchBox Themes and Media, and from here, you can update. And most of these should be updated shortly to support the new progress badge system. Yeah, as you can see right here, new progress badge system. So we've got that active, done or beaten, completed, done, dropped, got all of them ready to go with this white outline version. And of course, with all of the new RetroArch and progress integration, our on-the-fly filter system also supports it. So from here, go to progress, not started, unplayed. And once you've completed games with this in place, you have the done and master option right here, ready to go. And of course, with all of this, we can also filter our progress. So we can just show the games that are not started, active, done, right here, ready to go. This also works in Big Box. The progress status and badges will show in the default theme. Game progress can be changed manually from the game's menus inside of Big Box, and automation also works just like it does in LaunchBox. The last major feature that I want to show you here are hybrid views in Big Box. This is really awesome. Let's go ahead and move over there now. Here we are in Big Box, and right now I'm on my platform Wheel 1. With these new hybrid views, I'm a big fan of them. They're designed to be fast for clean navigation. It's a smooth experience out of the box. And just taking a look at Platform Hybrid 1, you can see we can just go right over, choose our game directly from here. We can navigate different platforms right from the left-hand side. And it switches over super quickly when we want to get into our game view section. We've got our videos, everything going here. These look really good. Hybrid View 2, this is actually my favorite because it's super quick. For instance, Nintendo, if I press Enter or A on my controller, we can just go right here. Choose a new game. We can come back down. Game Boy. Want to get in here, play a game directly from Game Boy. Not a problem to do so. And we've got our Platform Hybrid 3. So it gives us that top menu. And again, just pressing Enter or A, we're already in our game section, ready to choose something to play. These are going to be great for developers and just offer a whole new theme experience for custom themes in the future. Theme developers will be able to add up to 4 hybrid views per theme. And the final thing I want to show you here is a brand new theme built on hybrid views known as Ethereal. So I'm going to install it now. I'll apply it as my main theme. And here it is. So this is a very slick theme, as you can see, and it's really quick. Boom, ready to go. I can just scroll through this, no problem at all. Hit my back button or escape, depending on if you're using a keyboard or a controller. We can just find the next section that we want to go to. So this is the new Ethereal theme that you can download inside a Big Box. And personally, I cannot wait to see what theme developers do with these new hybrid views. That's going to wrap it up for this video. We hope you enjoyed LaunchBox 13.22. Definitely give it a try. If you've got any questions or need any help with anything, we've got the full forum. Link for that is in the description. Like always, thanks for watching.